रिकग्निशन ऑफ एसेट्स एंड रीअसेसमेंट ऑफ लाइबिलिटीज। इसके बाद भी एक पार्ट है आपका एडजस्टमेंट ऑफ कैपिटल, बट दैट पार्ट आई विल नॉट टीच यू नाउ, उसको हम लोग इसके बाद जब हम लोग एडमिशन पढ़ेंगे उसी में ज्यादा एलेबोरेट करके हम लोग समझ सकते हैं। सो वी विल डेफर इट नाउ फॉर द नेक्स्ट वीडियो, राइट। सो व्हाट इज रीवैल्यूएशन ऑफ एसेट्स एंड रीअसेसमेंट ऑफ लाइबिलिटीज, व्हाट डज इट मीन? द वैल्यू ऑफ एसेट्स समटाइम इट मे डिफर फ्रॉम द बुक वैल्यू बिकॉज विथ टाइम द वैल्यू ऑफ एसेट्स मे इंक्रीज और मे डिक्रीज, राइट। समझ में आ गया? द वैल्यू ऑफ एसेट्स मे डिफरेंट that different from their book value because with the time value of assets may increase or decrease. Similarly, in case of liabilities, it is possible that the amount payable in different from that of the available in the books. It is also possible that some assets or liabilities are not recorded in the books. That is why the value of assets and liabilities payable should be brought to their current values so that the partner should not gain or suffer loss. So when there is a change in the profit sharing ratio, gaining partner is supposed to compensate the sacrificing partner in case of any profit, right? That is why the reason for revaluation of assets and reassessment of liabilities is that any increase or decrease in the value of assets and liabilities up to the date of change, jab tak jis date tak change ho raha hai in profit sharing ratio is for the period before the change in profit sharing ratio. Therefore, it is shared by the partners in the respective profit sharing ratio, right? So here one more important thing is there that the partners may decide to record the revised figure or reassessed figure in the new books or new balance sheet of the firm, or it may so happen that they may decide not to change the value or not to alter the value of assets and liabilities. Now let us go through the practical parts so that you can have a better understanding. Revaluation account is also it is a nominal account and it is also known as profit and loss adjustment account. Right? Revaluation account is a nominal account and it is also known as profit and loss adjustment account. Debit side records, you just see the formats. Increase in the value of liabilities, entry count here, revaluation account debited to liabilities account. Liabilities by default always shows credit. So if I want to increase it, it is to be credited again. Decrease in the value of assets. Assets by default always shows debit. If I want to decrease it, it is to be credited. Next, for unrecorded liabilities, if some unrecorded liabilities are there and we want to bring it into the books, then it will be revaluation account debited to unrecorded liabilities account. The name of the liabilities will be given. Similarly, in case of increase in the value of assets, assets account debited to revaluation account. Asset value has been increased, debited. Decrease in the value of liabilities, entry will be liabilities account debited to revaluation account. Unrecorded assets increased, assets name of the asset will be given. So asset account debited to revaluation account. If the debit total is more, there will be loss and that loss is to be transferred to partner's capital account, old partner's capital account or current account in the old ratio. Important part, that is to be shared in the old ratio, right? That is old ratio. I am writing OR, old ratio, here it is also old ratio. And in case of if the credit side is more, there will be profit and that profit should be transferred to partner's capital account or current account in the old ratio, whatever the case may be. One most important thing is, just remember, when I am talking about the increase or decrease, by paying cash to the creditor or by paying cash to the other liabilities or by paying cash to purchase an asset, that should not be treated as increase or decrease. Most important part, assets or liabilities should not be increased or decreased by purchasing or by paying it off, right? It should be revalued or reassessed. In case of assets, it is to be revalued and in case of liabilities, it is to be reassessed. We will work it out. Practical questions will help you to understand it in a better way, right? So, this side it records increase in the value of liabilities, decrease in the value of assets, unrecorded liabilities, and in case of profit. And this credit side records, increase in the value of assets, decrease in the value of liabilities, and unrecorded assets and loss in case of loss. And remember, when revaluation account is prepared, assets and liabilities are to be shown at their revalued figure or revised figure. Again, I am telling you, I will explain the items with the help of a practical question. It will help you to understand it in a better way. Number one. Number two, it is very important to go through the questions very carefully, because some technical terms will be there and you have to understand it. Then only you can pass the necessary journal entries. Right. So now let us work out one practical question. So we have so far discussed about the revaluation account, and we have already prepared the revaluation of the format of revaluation account. Right. You can also write the journal entries, although I have discussed it. Write down the journal entries, it will be better for you to understand it. Now, for increase in the value of assets, or for recording unrecorded assets. For increase in the value of assets or for recording unrecorded assets, journal entry will be sundry assets account, the name of the asset will be there. Sundry assets account debited to revaluation account. Similarly, for increase in the value of liabilities or for recording unrecorded liabilities, entry will be revaluation account debited to sundry liabilities account. If the name is given, write down the name. Similarly, for writing off of an asset, suppose an asset is there and now it is valueless or it is of no use, we have to write it off. The entry will be revaluation account debited to assets account. And for writing off of liabilities, the entry will be liabilities account debited to revaluation account. And if there is profit, that profit will be shared by old partners, old issue. That is very important. Old partner in the old issue. And the entry will be revaluation account debited to partner's capital account. And in case of loss, just reverse the entry. Partner's capital account or current account debited to the revaluation account. Now let us work out a practical problem so that it will be more clear. And very important part is that you have to be very careful about the wordings of the question, because the question itself determines the answer. Now you see the question what I have written here. A, B and C are partners sharing profit and loss in the ratio of 5:3:2. Remember, this is the old ratio. 5:3:2, this is the old ratio. Now they have decided to share the future profit in the ratio of 2:5:3. Now this is the new ratio with effect from 1st April 2014. An extract of their balance sheet as on 31st March 2014 is as under. It is given land and building 84,000, plant and machinery 80,000, stock 63,000, patent 6,000, intangible asset, patent 6,000, debtors, inner column 60,000, less provision 5,000. So total comes to 55,000. And in the liability side, creditors 40,000, outstanding rent 80,000, and bills payable 7,000. I have not totaled it because it is an extract, so total items are not there. What are the additional information? Although I have incorporated many additional information, but remember such a long questions may not be asked, but you have to prepare. Land and building is found overvalued. Wording is very important. Found overvalued by 5%. Plant and machinery to be decreased by 20%. Right. Then stock is found undervalued by 10%. Patents are valueless. Wordings. English wordings is very important. Right. Patents are valueless. Next. Debtors are all good. Unrecorded furniture worth ₹12,000 to be brought into the books. It was unrecorded. Remember. This is unrecorded. Unrecorded furniture. Debtors are all good. These terms you should remember. Debtors are all good. Unrecorded furniture worth ₹12,000 to be brought into the books. And unaccounted claim. Unaccounted means it was not recorded earlier. Unaccounted claim for damage for ₹8,000 to be provided for. And creditors include an item of ₹6,000 which is not likely to be claimed. Not likely to be claimed. Right. So what we have to do? you are required to show the effect of above transactions when the partners, we have decided, we have taken two cases. First case is when the partners have decided to record the revalued figure, means the revised figure or the new figure in the new balance sheet. And second one, if the partners have decided not to alter, not to change or remain unchanged, remain undisturbed the value of assets and liabilities in the new balance sheet. Right? So this is the question. While working out a question, you should very carefully go through all the transactions very carefully. Remember, again I am telling you, such a long question may not be asked, particularly both ISM, CPC, you may not be asked, but still then we have to prepare ourselves, right? So according to the prudence concept. So all anticipated losses we know. So that is why always prepare, keep yourself prepared, because any type of questions may be asked. And very important part is that, again I am telling you, go through the questions very carefully. Right? Now let us start with the working of the question we have already discussed. The first adjustment you see, first adjustment is given land and building found overvalued by 5%. What does it mean? The total is always, we know the total is always 100%. The total is always 100% and it is given that it is found that it is overvalued by 5%. Means say total is 100% and if it is 5% more, that means overvalued. What is that? Means jo bhi hai, that is 105%. Right? Land and building ka value given is 84,000. So I can say that 105% is equal to 84,000. Jada ho gaya hai. So what will be 100%? How to calculate it? 84,000 by 105 into 100. It comes to 80,000. So jo land and building ka value 80,000 hona chahiye, it has been recorded at 84,000. It means it is 4,000, it is overvalued by 4,000. Now we have to reduce it. Entry kya hota hai? Land and building reduce hona hai, it is an asset. So entry of a revaluation account debited to land and building account. Revaluation account debited to land and building account. How much? It is 4,000. Right? Next one. It is given that plant and machinery to be decreased by, remember, decreased by, ek aur wording hota hai, decreased to. Dono ka meaning alag hai. Decreased by 20% means I value kitna 80,000. So 80,000 will be reduced by 20% means 80,000 will be reduced by 16,000. Matlab value kitna hona chahiye? 80,000 minus 16,000, it will be 64,000. Right? But maan lo, agar yahi pe diya hua hota, plant and machinery to be decreased to 20%, tab kitna hoga? Plant and machinery ka tab value ho jata 16,000. Matlab hum log ko reduce karna padta 64,000. Are you getting it? Decreased by and decreased to, decreased by 20% diya matlab utna hi kam karna hai. So decreased by 20%, that 20% comes to 16,000. So we will reduce the plant and machinery by 16,000. Entry will be revaluation account debited to plant and machinery account by 16,000. Right? Next one. Stock is found overvalued. Stock is found undervalued by 10%. Stock is found undervalued. Total, just now we have discussed. Total is always 100%, undervalued by 10%, less over, means whatever value we have, it represents 90% of the total value. So 90% is equal to 63,000, means 100% will be equal to how much? 63,000 by 90 into 100, it comes to 70,000. So the value of land and building will be, sorry, stock will be 70,000, but the stock is valued at 63,000, or it is shown at 63,000. Means we have to increase it by another 7,000. Entry will be stock account debited to revaluation account or revaluation account credited by stock account, that is 7000. Right? Next one. Patents are valueless. What does it mean? Patent appears at the in the book is at 6000 and the question says it is valueless. Means as on date the patent value is zero. तो अगर जीरो करना है मतलब पेटेंट को पूरा रिड्यूस करना है. एसेट्स विल डिक्रीज. एंट्री होगा रिवॉल्यूशन अकाउंट डेबिटेड टू एसेट अकाउंट. इन दिस केस रिवॉल्यूशन अकाउंट डेबिटेड टू पेटेंट अकाउंट. टू पेटेंट इट द वैल्यू इज हाउ मच 6000. राइट. नेक्स्ट डेटर्स आर ऑल गुड. नाउ यू सी for the debtors there is a provision of 5000. That means we expect that there will be a bad debt of 5000. But now the question says debtors are all good. Means there will be no bad debt. So when there will be no bad debt means there will be no need of maintaining any provision. Provision is already existing at 5000. Provision is a liability. Now since debtors are all good, we need not to create any provision. So that provision has to be cancelled or has to be eliminated or decreased. So entry will be all written off. The entry will be provision for bad debt account debited. Provision for bad debt account debit to revaluation account decrease in the value of liability. Right. Or the entry will be the one posting current account may. What will the entry? Revaluation account credited by provision for bad debt. It is how much? Provision for bad debt is 5000. Right. Next one. Next is given unrecorded furniture worth rupees 12000 to be brought into the book. Unrecorded furniture. Now you see in the balance sheet furniture is not there. That means the furniture is unrecorded. That is unrecorded asset. Thoda yaad karo apko format ko. Unrecorded assets means there will be an increase in the value of asset. The entry will be furniture account debited to revaluation account or revaluation account is credited by furniture account. Right? For entry ho gaya furniture account debited to revaluation account. Or revaluation account credited by furniture account 12000. Right. Next one. An unaccounted claim for rupees 8000 to be provided for. Unaccounted claim means it was claimed but we have not recorded it earlier. Now we have to record it. Means there is an increase in liability. Unaccounted claim. So claim is a liability. Previously it was not recorded. Now I have to record it. The entry will be revaluation account debited to claim for damages or unaccounted claim भी आप लिख सकते हो. Claim for damages लिखो. Claim for damages is 8000. Right? Unaccounted claim. Next, creditors for rupees, creditors included an item of 6000 which is not likely to be claimed. Creditor include, my creditor balance is how much? 40000. But it includes an item of 6000 which is not to be paid, not to be claimed. Means हम लोग को 6000 का claim देना नहीं पड़ेगा. अगर मेरे को 6000 का claim देना नहीं पड़ेगा, what does it mean? The creditor will be reduced. Creditor is a liability. Now if I want to reduce it, it is to be reversed. तो journal entry होगा creditors account debited to revaluation account or revaluation account credited by creditors account. That is how much? That is 6000. Next, so now there are two questions we are again asked to do. The first one is given that if the partners have decided not to change the value of assets and liabilities. Remember, normally when we prepare the revaluation account, assets and liabilities, the value of the assets and liabilities will be changed or will be recorded at the revised value or revalued figure. Right? So first part, let us calculate the profit or loss. That is that the loss of 4000 by loss, right? So that loss is to be borne by old partners in the old ratio, right? By is capital account or current account. Here it will be capital account, no current account, because if nothing is given in, so you could presume that the capital account is fluctuating. By A is capital account, B is capital account, and C is capital account. Right. So loss amount is how much? This total comes to 34,000. Now till now it is 30,000. So there is a loss of 4,000. Right? So 4,000 in the ratio 5:3:2. So he will get, he is to bear 2,000 rupees. And $1,200 and $800. Total comes to 4,000 loss to be shown in the capital account. Right? So if this happens when reversion account is prepared, what will happen? Now in the new balance sheet, that land and building which was earlier sold or originally shown at 84,000 will be shown at 80,000. Plant and machinery will be shown at how much? Plant and machinery will be reduced by 16, means it will be shown at 64,000. Stock will be shown at 70,000. There will be no patent because patents are very less. We have already written it, write it off. Then debtors, I mean provision aayega nahi. Net debtors will be there. That is 60,000. Furniture was not there, but now we have to record that furniture will be valued at 12,000. Similarly, on the liability side, creditors may pass jo 40,000 ke the. Now it will be shown at 34,000 because 6,000 has been written off, unclaimed debt, outstanding rent will be there, bills payable will be there, one more liability will be there which was unaccounted earlier, that is claim for damages. It should not be shown. Right? Next. Now suppose in the second bill it is given that when the partners have decided not to change the value of assets and liabilities. Remember, usko aur bhi kai tarika se sentences ho sakte hain. That the partners have decided not to change, not to alter, remain unchanged, remain unaltered. Is there a wording ho sakta hai? Means old balance sheet jo tha wahi hoga, no changes. At that time, what we will do? Uske liye accounting term mein memorandum revolution account, which is not in your syllabus. So that is why what we used to do, we used to prepare one statement. That statement kya hai? Statement showing the effect of revaluation of assets and reassessment of liabilities. Almost statement same, simply we need not to pass entries, and as we are not passing any entry, it is not giving any effect to the assets and liabilities. So kaise hoga, dekho aap statement form mein bana rahe hain, since it is a statement, no debit or credit is there. Increase in the value of assets and decrease in the value of liabilities to be added. Increase in the value of assets and decrease in the value of liabilities to be added. Abhi hum log banaye the 10 iske pehle jo banaye the, hum log dekho revolution account usko dekhe bana rahe the. Stock का वैल्यू इंक्रीज हुआ था 7,000. प्रोविजन फॉर बैड डेट डिक्रीज इन द वैल्यू ऑफ लायबिलिटीज, इट वाज एडेड, इट इज एडेड. फर्नीचर हम लोग अनअकाउंटेड था, वी हैव ब्रॉट इन टू द बुक्स, सो इंक्रीज इन द एसेट एडेड. एंड क्रेडिटर्स अनक्लेम्ड है, वी नीड नॉट टू पे देम, डिक्रीज इन द लायबिलिटी, इट इज ऑल्सो एडेड. सिमिलरली डिक्रीज इन द वैल्यू ऑफ एसेट्स एंड इंक्रीज इन द वैल्यू ऑफ लायबिलिटीज टू बी डिडक्टेड. लैंड एंड बिल्डिंग वैल्यू डिक्रीज, इट वॉज फाउंड ओवर वैल्यू, सो नाउ इट इज डिक्रीज. Now plant and machinery, it was overvalued, decreased. Patent 6,000 rupees to be written off, and claim for damages new liability. Right? So, abhi isko hum dekha hai. If the positive side is more than the negative side, it will have given us profit on revaluation. But in this case, the negative is more and then the positive. So the difference is 4,000 rupees negative. Now this is negative loss only. Right, so अभी हम इफेक्ट कैसे देंगे? In this case, what will happen when there is a change in the ratio? Let us first calculate the gaining ratio or sacrificing ratio. Now you see, A was getting 5/10 as per the old ratio. Now he is getting 2/10, means he is sacrificing 3/10. Right? B was getting 3 by 10, now is getting 5 by 10, means he is gaining 3 by 2 by 10, and C is also gaining 1 by 10. What does it mean? A is sacrificing, B and C, they are gaining, and there is a loss. Now, in case of loss, that loss means in future, B and C, they are going to bear maximum more loss in comparison to A. So, that B and C will be compensated by A in case of loss. In case of loss, the sacrificing partner will compensate the gaining partner. On the other hand, in case of gain, agar yahan pe profit hua hota, profit on devaluation agar hua hota, then B and C would have compensated A. So, we entry kya ho gaya? A is capital account debited. Kita? Loss for the 4000. He is sacrificing 3 by 10. So, 4000 into 3 by 10. That is to be debited to A's capital account, to B's capital, to C's capital. Kita? Jiska jita jita gain hua hai. 4000 into 2 by 10 and 4000 into 1 by 10. Right? Next. Now, the net effect will be, after preparing this statement, the effect will be that there will be no change in the existing balance sheet. तो अभी मेरे पास जो बैलेंस शीट है अभी भी लैंड एंड बिल्डिंग विल बी शोड एट 84,000, प्लांट एंड मशीनरी 80,000, स्टॉक 63,000, पेटेंट 6,000, डेटर्स वही 60,000 माइनस 5,000, 55,000, क्रेडिटर्स 40,000, आउटस्टैंडिंग लैंड 8,000, बिल्स पेबल 7,000. सो व्हेन दैट व्हेन इज द क्वेश्चन इज गिवन दैट देयर दैट इज नॉट टू बी देयर द एसेट्स एंड लायबिलिटीज आर नॉट टू बी डिस्टर्ब्ड. Always remember that we have to prepare the memorandum revaluation account to bana nahi sakte because it is not in our syllabus. That is why we have to prepare one statement, and that statement should be prepared in a fair manner. And in case of profit, the gaining partner has to compensate the sacrificing partner. In case of loss, the sacrificing partner is to compensate the gaining partner. Right?